Hello, so today we're going to be taking care of the animals. So let me just run on over to our feeding truck here. And right now I'm just going to drive right up and over the little bit of silage that we have left here. Okay, so this first round is going to be completely straw, and then I'm going to do an entire load of grass, and I'm going to do a mix. This is working out a lot better than I expected, so that's always a plus. Okay, so one more should do it. So as you can tell, we're fully loaded, and I'll just back on up here and get ready to go dump all of our straw. You like that hay, don't you, Mr. Cow? Right, actually, that entire wagon back there is full of grass, so I'm gonna go grab this tractor here and go hook up to it really quick. And normally I'd fill up all the stuff a lot more, but just for demonstration purposes, I'm just gonna kind of keep things short and sweet, and then start working on working ground. Alright, so let's just back it up. Yeah, so the grass is full for 6 days. That's nice. So let's just cut her back and we'll get back to doing some extraction. Let me just double check something really quick. Okay, so we do need quite a bit of mixed rations, so I'll do 2 loads of mixed rations, and then I'll take the wagon and the tractor up to go feed the sheep, actually. So. So, some of you may know, and others may not, but for mixed rations, you need 1 straw bale and 1 grass bale, and then you top it off with silage. And I will take a straw bale from here, and I'll take a grass bale from the small little stack over in field 40 to my left. Yeah, those stacks right over there. Unfortunately, I've yet to find a really good spot that I like to use to store bales. Oh, come on, there we go. I was using the shed right there to store round bales, but it just was too long of a drive to get everything taken care of. But I'm sure I'll get this figured out. So as you can see, we're at 66%, and I am going to fill up the other 33% with silage over here. Drive up the rest of the pile and go dump. Oh, and as you can see in the upper left hand corner, there is the hay, the silage, and the straw mixing. And you can see that all of them are balanced, so that means I have a mixed ration. So let's dump it into the feed. So let's go get a second. So like I said in my last video, I'm planning on working the ground and planting corn, and we're just going to have one big corn harvest, and I'm really hoping that I can find a way to get my friends on so we can do the corn harvest together. Otherwise it's going to take a very long time for myself to harvest it all, even if I hire workers out to harvest for me. Alright, so since I've already fed the left side, I'm just gonna drive around to the other side so they can get fed over there. Even though I don't believe it really matters for the sake of the game, but it matters to me. Yeah, all of my cows get fed equally. Out here really quick. No way I can get in to get the wagon. Pay a considerably high price per check that out really quick. That's quite a bit for canola. Okay, so I'm gonna slow down time here. That way we don't miss out, even though we're not going to. This upcoming harvest is going to be a corn harvest, so I can resupply my storage for corn, and then the following harvest is going to be canola. I'm glad we got that figured out. Right. So, let's get ready to take off. Right. And it is quite a bit of a long drive, so let's see if I can find a good radio station to listen to. Hopefully there isn't any commercials.
Baby.
We'll go on to the next turn. That way I can show you these fields on the right here. Fields 5 and 6, I think are going to be my next project for joining. They have the trees going right down the center of them, but I think we can work around them and still make it a very effective field. And pending fields 2 and 3 on my left here, we'll join those together to make a nice big field. Actually, I think I'd join fields 5, 6, and 7. Make one really nice field. Beyond that, most of the fields are already kind of at their full extent. I can't really extend them much more without taking out some important roads or stuff like that. Man, it's awful bumpy here in town. Here's the turn. And as you can see, I have two pallets that are full of wool, but I don't have that many sheep. And we all have another pallet that's getting awful close. So let's get these guys fed. There you go, guys. Enjoy. Faster way to get home. I believe that's all downhill, so we'll go to the left here. As long as the coast is clear. Okay, let's go. Apologize for that. I'm a little back heavy, so I can't really steer. We'll just turn this lot here. So hopefully I can find another good radio station to listen to as we cruise along. Baby, your song, you make me wanna roll my windows down and cruise. Hey baby. Yeah, when I first saw that bikini top. Oh, and if you've been kind of wondering what the gold dots on my mini-map in the lower left-hand corner are? Those are actually gold coins that you can go and collect throughout the game. And if you collect them all, and you go to this specific place, you'll get some type of reward. And unfortunately, I am not sure what that is, because as you can tell, I still have quite a few gold coins to go collect. Alright, so without any further ado, I'll turn the radio back up and hopefully speed this thing up a little bit. Girl, you sure got the beat in my chest bumping. Hell, I can't get you out of my head. Alright, so now that we're back, I'll just get the wagon where I want it, and then I will get ready to go start working ground. And actually, I think with the time that I have left, I'm going to just get the equipment to the field that I'm going to start working. Fields number 34 and number 39. I already worked those fields, so I won't have to go up there and take care of those. So first field that I'm going to go take care of will be thinking field, the cluster of fields 24, 25, 29, and 30. And like I said, I think I'm just going to get them all lined up and ready to go for next episode. Alright, so now that we're here, let's get going. See how poorly I lined up. Actually, not too bad. Pretty close. Okay, well, so since I'm kind of running low on time, I'll leave you here, and when we come back next time, hopefully I'll have this field fully cultivated, and we'll probably start working on field, the big field with the cluster 22, 27, 32, and 33, and get that all cultivated and ready for the corn plant. So, thanks for watching.